Hey guys, I'm here with I don't want to think of it as a review, kind of, just more of a, this is kind of cool, I like this, I want to show it off type thing. And actually, in the title, this is the coolest or best DVD set that I've ever purchased. I'm not sure what the title is going to be exactly, but I have a general idea. Now, what this DVD set is, Blade Runner, the 5-disc collector edition type thing, whichever one to call it. So get it right there. Very nice overall packaging. like I said, this is easily the best DVD case, the DVD set I've ever seen. And I'm leaving it out to you. If you guys have seen one that is equally as awesome as this, drop me a comment, let me know, and let me have a little collection going here. So here we have this little case. I'm gonna go ahead and slide this off real quick. Just nice little. It helps protect. I find it funny. I got this from Amazon, right? And normally they come in these oversized Amazon boxes. I mean, you know, they'd go probably from here, and they just, you know, they'd probably fit this size of the box. This comes in an Amazon box, but inside that is a smaller box that is around this perfectly, and it's like remove packaging before putting out for display type thing. So it's nice that they're putting out that kind of care, you know, to make sure that this doesn't get any, you know, any dents or dings or anything. So here's this little sleeve that we get, and this kind of shows what is included in the overall set. It is a 5-disc DVD, limited edition packaging, 9 hours of special features, disc one. And I'll cover these a little more in detail when I open it up. Disc 1 has The Final Cut, which was out in 07. Disc 2 has Dangerous Days, The Making of Blade Runner. Disc 3 has 3 versions of it. The original domestic, the international, or the original, yeah, original domestic, original international cut, and then the 1992 director's cut. Disc 4 has Enhancement Archive, which is pretty much a lot of just little bonus stuff thrown in. Disc 5 is an ultra-rare pre-release work print. So in this set alone, you're getting 5 versions of the movie. It's cool to see how it's kind of advanced. You have the work print, which I believe came before the original domestic. So then you got work print, domestic, international, the rush director's cut, and then the final version. Each, from my understanding, has been restored to pristine type quality conditioning, that kind of thing. So here's some more bonus things. You get a little motion film clip, which I will show. Don't worry. A little replica of a police spinner, a little replica of the origami unicorn that was at the end of the film, I do believe. I know it's at the end of the film, but I'll get that out. All the discs included, and just some nice little, hey, my lamp went out, isn't that nice? Some little kind of drawings that were done by Sid Mead. He was hired to work on the vehicle designs of the movie, but his background stuff was really that impressive that they used it to as kind of like a template and made the movie kind of with those backgrounds. Nice little treat. So let me get my lamp back on. It has a tendency to click off on its own. It's a very old lamp, but I like it. We've had it since we moved in, so I can get rid of it. Now here you have the actual case. It is a briefcase. On the top, you can flip a little handle. You can hold it. You can carry it. If you look on the bottom, it's actually limited to 103,000, which, yeah, there's a lot of them, but factoring 103,000 in the entire world, not bad. There's mine there. And it is, you know, it's kind of like a kind of a thick plastic, maybe very thin metal in some parts, but it's mostly plastic. Overall, nice briefcase. Here's the front here. It's got two little press here buttons. You push those, and it's going to unlock the top of it, so you can slide it up. And here is the inside of it, all through here. So, you open it, the first thing you see is this little piece of plastic. That is, it's an interesting little thing to add in. It's a letter from Ridley Scott, as you can see here. And it's just, you know, talks about the final cut, just kind of some background stuff for the movie, and it's got some smudges on it already, even though I just got it. But, you know, it's a cool little nod to throw in. And, yeah, if you want to read it, here, I'm going to put it right here. You can go ahead and pause this if you want, okay? I'm going to bring it up there, all right? There you go. Can you read it? All right. And then I'm going to bring it up here. There you go. Okay, so hopefully you can read all that. If not, then that was a waste of my time and yours. Hey, hey. Now, on to the next bit of a... I guess I'll go to the origami thing next. Here's everything kind of laid out to show how it all looks and fits in place. I open this little foam packaging here, and you have a... It's a little plastic replica of the origami unicorn that was left at the end of the movie. Now, I just want to warn you, I've watched Blade Runner exactly one time. One. So, I'm looks like I'm forgetting a lot of things from the movie. But the overall point of Blade Runner is Harrison Ford plays a guy named Rick Deckard. He is a Blade Runner, which is someone who hunts down... In the movie, they're called replicants. And they're basically androids, if you will. His job is to round up any replicants that come to Earth since they are illegal on Earth. The movie is basically, I believe it's six of them, steal a shuttle from the moon, come on Earth, and start killing people. And it's his job to basically kill them. And it's him coming out of retirement to track down these machines. And that's kind of the whole Blade Runner story in a nutshell. But nice little detail. Next, we have, and this kind of impressed me, we have a police spinner, which is a, you know, the cop car, the future type thing. The doors actually open, which I didn't really expect. So you have that little feature. There is some interior inside, not a whole lot of really just, you know, nothing really to really, you know, go crazy about. But it is nice. And I think actually, I was thinking it's one of those where you can back it up and it'll spring forward. But it's just that the rubber wheels are kind of tight. But just is you know, it's an interesting little thing to include. I like it. Next, go to the back here. I'll set this little button. You can unsnap it. And we have the motion clip. Now, this is the second one that I've ever gotten. The first one was in the Wanted DVD set, which is itself, I think, pretty good. A lot of people don't like Wanted, but I think it's a good movie. I don't mind it. So here's the motion clip. When you move it, as you can tell, it has motion. Hey, isn't that cool? So, and these basically, each of these little dots are magnets, and it holds the two plastic ends together. The inside piece is just basically that. Still, nice detail. Wish I had a place to actually display all the stuff. I'll just have to have the case, but, cool little thing to throw in. I know that went a little too long. Now, in the back here, we've got this little folder that has Blade Runner. And this is basically some artwork that was done by Sid Mead. And one thing that I actually didn't really know of, and I looked it up because I wanted to know more about Sid Mead. He's done a lot of work. He helped design V'ger from the original Star Trek motion picture. He helped design Johnny, the robot from Short Circuit. And yeah, he's worked on movies like Time Cop, Aliens. He's done a lot of big things, and this is all his work. So remember, you know, they hired him to kind of work on the vehicles, and actually I think points this out in the back here. Yeah, he was hired to design the vehicles of Blade Runner, but his backgrounds were so good that Ridley Scott was like, hey, make the environments of the movie type thing too. And that's just a little example of how the movie looked there. You get this one, you get that one. That one. There's one there. And there's one there. And there's one there. And there's that one. And then there's that one. It each has, you know, little facts about just Sid Mead in general. Little deal that they really did have to include, but I love this kind of bonus stuff that's thrown in. Definitely awesome. And the folder itself has a lot of nice little artwork on it as well. So there's that. Now on to the actual reason to buy this set, the movie. Open up here, and for my understanding, this is the standard 5-disc Ultimate Collector Edition type thing. I think you can buy this separately without getting the whole case. The case will probably add 30, 40 bucks to the actual purchase, I'm guessing here. But here's the DVD case. Get this out here. Slides out. And here you have all of your discs. Nice little artwork here, and all these. There's all the discs. A lot of stuff thrown in. Now, there's a lot of movie stuff in here. The original work print version, which is back here on disc 5, is 113 minutes. It was shown to an audience test preview. I'm reading this trailer from Wikipedia, just to help you out. And it pretty much was a setup for the theatrical cut. The fans kind of, you know, people watching it had their own little opinions, so they went back and they made the original domestic cut, which is 116 minutes. And from that, you got the international cut, that's 117 minutes, and then you have the director's cut, which was, from my understanding, very, very rushed, didn't have the actual approval from Ridley Scott, and it was 116 minutes, with, I think it had, like, you know, more action, more of that kind of stuff thrown in. But the only version that has the full approval of Ridley Scott is the final cut, which is 117 minutes. Come out 2007. I'm actually excited to watch it, see what's all different from the original. So then you got Disc 2, which is a 3-hour making of Blade Runner. I think it's longer than 3 hours, but it's like 3 hours and so-and-so minutes of making of Blade Runner, showing all the nitty-gritty details behind it and stuff that I just go insane for. Then you got Disc 4, which is the Enhancement Archive. And just so I can clearly say what that is about, the Enhancement Archive is audiovisual mosaic of more than a dozen segments, crawling the aspects of production, plus focuses on Sid Mead, Jordan Cronenweth, DVD restoration, and vintage featurettes. A lot of stuff is in this set. So if you are a fan of Blade Runner, you may want to pick this up. If you have never seen Blade Runner, you may want to check it out. This is one of the staples of, you know the whole sci-fi type action movie. And it really changed how movies were for years to come. And it's definitely worth the money. You kind of missed out, though. Amazon had this whole set on sale for like $35. I think if you want it now, its retail price is around $80. Amazon has it for about $55. I would definitely recommend picking it up. It is truly an awesome thing to own. And I am very glad that I was able to pick it up. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.